Hello and welcome to my next video on functions. In this part we will learn how to pass arrays and we will also see how to write header files. So first thing you note here is I have included a header func2.h. Now I'll talk about that later. And once again notice that the video is recorded at 720p, so watch in 720p for better viewing. Okay, so I have an integer array I of 5 elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I have a character array of 6, size 6, hello. Then I pass I, 5, and C. Now I is the base pointer of array I, C is the base pointer of C, that is address of the 0th element. And these are called actual argument or formal parameters. S is missing because it should be plural. The term formal parameters is deprecated. Many times when you will compile, then you will see deprecated. What does it mean? Deprecated means that later on this particular convention or meaning or term or facility will be removed. So you should try not to use it. So we will call this actual argument, and here I receive it as int pointer I and char pointer C and also the length as integer. Now these are also called formal argument, which is a deprecated name, or actual parameter. Here I iterate for length. Notice that for integer arrays or character arrays, you should pass length ideally. For integer arrays you should pass length. Why? Because over here I have no way to calculate the length of I, the pointer I. I can calculate the length of character pointer by calling strlen. Let's see what strlen does. So strlen calculates the length of a string. Now since I have no way to calculate the length of I, you must pass the length of array I, and then I simply print it. Now let's talk a little bit about function2.h. Now you'll see that even though function f is below main, I have not written its prototype. Why? Because the prototype has gone in the header called func2.h. Headers typically contain the prototypes. Here I have my prototype for function f, the same way as if I would have written it in the main func2.c. This is called header guard. So what it does is, if func2_h_ is not defined, it defines that, and then it has that prototype for function f, and then I end the if condition. These are preprocessor macros which you will see later. Now the result of this is, if I include it again, what will happen is, in the first inclusion that will be defined, func2_h_, the capitalized version or the name of the func2.h with underscores. Now in the first inclusion that will be defined, and in the second inclusion this if test will fail, and therefore it will not enter here. That is why this is called the header guard. And therefore when over here, instead of hash include, it will come as the prototype will come. So to show you, I'll show you how it looks. So after the pre-processing, this would be the status of your program. So you see how this has come here just before main. This is the actual file which gets passed to compiler after the preprocessor does the pre-processing. And you see that this has been included at func2, and the line numbers various. This is basically a hashed line macro which facilitates in debugging. More about this will come when we'll go through preprocessors specifically. So right now I just type make func2, so it is compiled. So I just say func2, and then you see the values are printed. So what did we learn? We learned that if we are passing anything other than a char pointer, which is a string whose length we can determine with strlen, then we must use the length in the function call. Second thing that which we learn is that these are called actual arguments and these are called actual parameters. A copy of length will come, please note that length will be coming as a copy on stack, not the actual value. And we also learn a little bit about header. Now why this is within double quotes and within this within Angular? Angular typically comes from library headers, and these are typically your user headers. So it's a kind of distinction. That is one of the reasons why it is in double quotes. Second thing is your dot directory is always within the include path, so this will be searched in the current directory. So otherwise you can use you can also use Angular bracket for this. For example, if you try, let's see if it works. Okay, so it says no, it cannot find. Why? Because it has no include path, it is not in the include path. So let's to put this in include path, what you need to do is you need to say I dot slash. Okay, it still cannot find func 2.h. So let me give it the full path. Okay. Okay, it still cannot find. Func2.h, no such header. Okay, it was after minus, so so it should be before minus, so it compiles. So if you give your, now I believe even dot will work. So once this minus capital I specifies one include path, you can have several minus capital I's. So you see, if you put it in include path, you can even use Angular brackets, but the double quotes is the distinction that it is a user header. That's it for this video. In my next video, I'll show you something more about functions. We will revisit our factorial program, and then we will revisit our Fibonacci series. We'll use and try to learn how to do recursion. Thanks for watching the video.